Hi class, how are you all? I just hope you all are doing good, studying every day, because we have to appear for our exams in the month of February. ठीक है, तो रोज थोड़ा 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 we have to study. And I have already told you, you must read 1 to 2 pages of English textbook. Lessons पढ़े हैं, but still we must go on, we must read. And with this, today we are going to discuss the second poem in your textbook, the Indian Weavers. Now the best part about this poem is that it is by an Indian writer, an Indian poet, Sarojini Naidu. Students, I'm sure you know Sarojini Naidu played a very important role in the Indian struggle for independence. All right, see, I have the background of the poet. She was a very famous poet, a political activist. Unka naam hamari history ke textbooks mein bhi milega. All right, she played an important role in the Indian independence struggle. All right. In spite of being a woman, it was not easy in those days, but still she's made it possible that it's because of her works we remember her even today. ठीक है, उनको महात्मा गांधी had given her a title, Nightingale of India. Nightingale is a small bird which sings beautifully. All right, so because of her poetic works, उन्होंने इतनी सारी कविताएं और इतना कुछ लिखा है कि जिसकी वजह से उनको महात्मा गांधी जी ने ये किताब दिया था. सो दैट इज अबाउट द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द पोएट. मूविंग ऑन, वी हैव द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द पोएम. अब इंडियन वीवर्स, जैसे कि पोएम का नाम है, हु इज अ वीवर? अ वीवर इज अ पर्सन हु वीव्स, वीव्स अ क्लॉथ. ठीक है, हिंदी में उसको कहेंगे बुनना, कपड़े जो बुनता है. जैसे महात्मा गांधी चरखा चला के कपड़े बनाते थे, उसी तरह जो कपड़े बुनते हैं, ऑल राइट, उनको बुनकर, तो उनको दे आर कॉल्ड एज वीवर्स. ऑल राइट, सो हियर थ्रू दीज वीवर्स द पोएट इज गिविंग अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मैसेज. ठीक है, नाउ हियर द पोएट टॉक्स अबाउट three different kinds of garments worn at important occasions by a person. Okay, the writer talks about three important clothes which are worn at, which we use at important occasions. So which are those clothes and what is their significance here? This you'll come to know as we proceed. Okay, so these garments are woven, that is stitched, they are weaved by weavers at different times of the day. ये जो weavers है, ये पूरे सुबह, शाम को और रात को ये अलग अलग टाइप के कपड़े बुनते हैं. तो अलग अलग टाइप पे जो ये अलग अलग किस्म के कपड़े बनाते हैं, what is their importance? Right? Now this poem is a celebration of the profession of our Indian weavers. A strong message is given by the poet, and that is propagation of Swadeshi goods and boycott of foreign goods. तो ये तब की poem है जब हमारी लड़ाई, आजादी की लड़ाई चल रही थी. Alright? And that time most of our activists, political activists, हमारे जो नेता थे, उन्होंने एक बहुत important बात सबको बताई थी कि हमें अपनी ही बनाई हुई चीजों को इस्तेमाल करना है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टू नोट दैट वी आर मूविंग बैक टू द ओल्डन टाइम्स, राइट? करेंटली वी आर ऑल्सो ट्राइंग टू बॉयकॉट फॉरेन गुड्स एंड वी आर एनकरेज्ड टू बाय गुड्स मेड बाय अवर ओन कंपनीज. ठीक है, एनीवे, मूविंग बैक टू द पोएम. All right, the poem describes three stages of human life, that is the birth, the marriage and death. In other way, it tells about the life cycle of a human being, means childhood, youth and old age. Now, students, let me just explain a little bit because this is related to the poem. All right, the poet considers that birth of a small baby is a miracle. It is important because it is symbolic to a new life. एक छोटा बच्चा जब घर में पैदा होता है तो that is a reason of celebration. उसी तरह जब किसी की शादी होती है, you know that is another beginning. So that is another occasion of celebration. That is marriage, right? But death, all right? When we lose somebody, all right? Then that is a very sad moment. दुखदायी समय होता है. But then why does the poet talk about this? All right? And what have the weavers got to do here? That we come to know as we read this poem. The process of creation in the universe is an endless one, like the weaving of the weavers who work from morning to night. Srishti mein, hamare srishti mein aisa as in the birth and the death, the process just continues. All right, it's a non-stop cycle. All right, we have so many children being born at the same time. We have people dying as well. So it's an endless cycle. Aur usi endless cycle ko hamari weavers, as in they are showing it through the poem. All right, ki kaise ye weavers, they are also working from morning till night. So this is also a very important symbol. Now structure of the poem. As I told you, this is a short poem, all right? And the best part, since it's written by an Indian writer, the English is really simple. The message is also clear. We are able to understand the poem in a much, much better way. There are three stanzas made up of four lines each. All stanzas follow a particular pattern. A question is asked by the poetess in the second line of the stanza. हम अगली स्लाइड में जब हम पोयम हम देखेंगे तो स्टूडेंट्स विल कम टू नो दैट ऑल द स्टैंजास देयर आर जस्ट थ्री स्टैंजास फोर लाइंस ईच एंड ऑल द स्टैंजास दे फॉलो अ पर्टिकुलर पैटर्न ऑलराइट द पोएटेस शी इज ट्राइंग टू आस्क दीज वीवर्स अ क्वेश्चन ऑलराइट एंड राइम स्कीम भी आसान है बिकॉज द फर्स्ट लाइन राइम्स विद द सेकेंड द थर्ड लाइन राइम्स विद द फोर्थ. Thus, the rhyme scheme, students, when the first and the second line are rhyming, we give them one common letter, right? So that way, the rhyme scheme is AABB. And the best part is that it is same for all the stanzas. All right? The poem consists of discussion between the poet and the weaver, where the poet is asking and the reply is given by the weavers. So students, that is how the poem is like. It is in a sort of a conversation. Now see students, you will notice that this poem is very different from the first poem, Song of the Open Zone. That poem just did not have any rhyming words. So poem that does not have any rhyming words is said to be in free verse. But this poem by Sarojini Naidu is different, because here we have a rhyme scheme, and that is AABB, because the first line rhymes with the second and the third line rhymes with the fourth. Now see, this is the poem, students. As you can see, three stanzas, just what we discussed, four lines each. A question is asked in every stanza, all right? And you will see that the words are rhyming. For instance, day rhymes with gay, wild rhymes with child. Similarly, night rhymes with bride, green with queen. Still and chill are rhyming. Well, as last two lines, cloud and shroud are again rhyming. So since the first line rhymes with the second, the rhyme scheme is AA. And since the third line rhymes with the fourth, The rhyme scheme is BB. Now we come to discussion of every stanza in detail. All right. Now see, this is the first stanza. Weavers weaving at break of a day. Why do you weave a garment so gay? Blue as the wing of a falcon white. We weave the robes of a newborn child. Oh, such a beautiful, beautiful lines there. The poet is asking that why do you weave a garment so gay? All right, your gay means beautiful, shining. All right, now this also tells us that the weavers, when are they working? At the break of a day. Break of a day means students, early morning, subha subha. See students, everything is symbolic. Theek hai? Subha, that is the morning, is symbolic, is a symbol of new life. Nayi shuruaat. Theek hai? Nayi shuruaat. So, usi tarah, see they are also at early morning when the day is new, bright. They are weaving a bright cloth. Gay meaning here, it's a bright shining cloth. And how is the cloth? It's blue in color. Blue as the wing of a falcon wild. Falcon is a bird like a kingfisher. I'll just show you how the bird is. The falcon is the bird like a kingfisher. Now students, can you see how beautiful the wings are of this bird? It's really tiny, but then the color that bird has given it is really beautiful. So the cloth, and now that you can imagine, the cloth is blue and shiny. We go back to the poem, students. Yes, here we are. So the cloth is blue and shining as the wing of a falcon wild. Falcon matlab ek pakshi hai jo maine aapko abhi abhi dikhaya, kingfisher kehte hain use. Theek hai? Aur wo kya kehte hain ki hum ye kapda kiske liye bana rahe hain? Hum ye kapda ek chote se abhi abhi janme hue bacche ke liye bana rahe hain. So the morning, students, is symbolic of a new beginning. Same way, a newborn child is again also a symbol of a new life. Theek hai? Now we read the explanation. The poetess observes some weavers weaving a bright blue cloth at the break of a day. Break of the day, I told you, is it morning. And she's asking them why and for whom are they stitching such a bright cloth? Okay, I have given there the meaning also. The weavers reply that they are weaving it for the dress of a newborn child. So I told you students, the newborn child is also a symbol of a new life. Thus the cloth they weave of blue color, as blue as the wings of falcon, that's a kingfisher. Okay, then the dawn of the daybreak, subha jo hoti hai, I told you it's the beginning of life, birth of a new life. And hence students, the third line, the figure of speech is simile. Simile means direct comparison. Jab koi do cheezo ko directly compare kiya jata hai using the words as ya fir like, then that figure of speech is simile. And so third line has a figure of speech simile, as the beauty of the garment is directly compared to the beauty of the wings of the bird. Us sundar shining kapde ko us pakshi ke pankhon ke sath compare kiya gaya hai. All right, we move on to the next stanza. Just before we move on, students, have a look at the pattern. You will find that in all the three stanzas, second line is a question. The third line is simile. and mostly in all the lines, the first line is alliteration. I repeat, mostly in all three stanzas, the first line is alliteration, the second line is a question, and the third line is a simile. All right. Now the second stanza. Weavers weaving at fall of night. Fall of night matlab sunset. It's almost sunset. Subah se sham ho gayi. फिर भी ये वीवर्स जो है ये कंटिन्यूस अपना काम किए जा रहे हैं. ठीक है. सो व्हाई डू यू वीव अ गारमेंट सो ब्राइट. गारमेंट मतलब कपड़ा. अब यहाँ पे वो और भी एक चमकीला कपड़ा स्टिच कर रहे हैं. एंड बट नाउ यू द कलर ऑफ द क्लॉथ हैज चेंज्ड. नाउ हियर व्हाट इज द कलर ऑफ द क्लॉथ. इट इज लाइक द प्लूम्स. प्लूम्स इज फेदर. इफ यू कैन सी स्टूडेंट्स, second point I have included the meaning of the word plume. Plume is a feather, like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green. We weave the marriage wreaths of a queen. The poetess is asking again, for whom are you stitching this garment which is so bright? So she gets an answer that this particular piece of cloth is purple and green is for a bride. ठीक है, ये किसी bride के लिए है, एक दुल्हन के लिए है. और wheel, wheel क्या होता है, दुल्हन के माथे पे जो घूंघट होता है, that's a wheel, V-E-I-L, alright? Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green. So how is the, now your students again, purple and green, alright? Are again symbols. You can see the third point, they are symbolic of fertility and growth. All right, it symbolizes new again. Later on, when this lady, she becomes a mother, she's a symbol of fertility and new life, new growth, and hence purple and green are symbols associated with a bride. Ek dulhan ke liye hai ye colors. Okay. So I read all the four points. At nightfall, the poetess finds the weavers weaving a cloth. And the cloth kaisa hai? It's bright, multicolored. And wo unko poochti hai, why do you weave a garment so bright? The weavers tell her that they are weaving a cloth of purple and green color, magnificent and colorful like the plumes of a peacock. Plumes, I've given their feathers. And this is the bridal dress of a queen. Of course, every bride is dressed like a queen for her wedding. Yes, that is what is the Indian tradition is like, or perhaps for that matter, tradition all over the world. Yahan pe a bride is no less than a queen. Purple and green are considered symbolic of fertility and growth. And students, again, as I told you, did you notice the first line is an alliteration? Alliteration, जब एक अक्षर repeat होता है, उसको alliteration कहते हैं. Weavers weaving. यहाँ पे WW repeat हो रहा है, so that's alliteration. Second line is a question. Third line is a simile, because the beauty of the garment is directly compared to the beauty of peacock's feathers. वो कपड़ा इतना सुंदर है जैसे कि एक मोर के फेदर्स है. ओके, प्लूम्स. प्लूम्स आर फेदर्स. वी मूव ऑन टू द लास्ट एंड द थर्ड स्टैंजा. अगेन स्टूडेंट्स, सी वीवर्स वीविंग सॉलेम एंड स्टिल. एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम the poetess is talking about the mood of the workers. How is the mood of the workers? Their mood is very solemn and still. Students, solemn is very serious. They are very serious and they are not very active. जैसे वो जोश था पहले दो stanzas में, जब वो एक बच्चे के लिए कपड़े बना रहे थे, जब वो एक दुल्हन का घूंघट बना रहे थे, that time the the spirit, the happiness that they were facing, that happiness is missing over here. And why is it missing? Let's read ahead. Why do you weave in the moonlight chill? बहुत रात हो गई है, ठीक है, and बहुत ठंड भी बढ़ गई है. Chill is ठंड. Now they get the answer. White as a feather, white as a cloud, we weave a dead man's funeral shroud. जैसे हम एक सफेद सफेद कपड़ा कब इस्तेमाल किया जाता है ना, see every all three stanzas the color is very important. Now your white cloth is used at a funeral. मरने के बाद शरीर को सफेद कपड़े में लपेट के लेके जाते हैं. So that is what, that is why, so somebody has died. कोई मर गया है एंड उसके लिए वो एक सफेद कपड़ा बना रहे हैं एंड इसके लिए दे आर वेरी सीरियस एंड दे आर वेरी क्वाइट. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स अगेन सी द फर्स्ट लाइन इज एलिटरेशन. वीवर्स वीविंग, W, the sound of letter W is repeated. Again, S, the sound of S, solemn, still, is repeated for better poetic effect. Second line is a question. Third line is again simile because the white cloud is directly compared to plain white cloth used to cover a dead body. Okay, white cloud. All right, white feather, so that color white is used to cover a dead body. Let's read. In a cold moonlight, the poetess finds the weavers still at work. She's surprised. Itni thand mein, itni raat ko bhi ye kaam kar rahe hain? But they are silent and their mood is serious. Now, which is the word, which is another word for serious from the four lines of the poem? Yes, it is solemn. The word solemn in the very first line means serious. They are now weaving a white cloth as wide as a bird's feather or a cloud. And then she is told that they are weaving it for a funeral shroud of a dead man, dead body. They are using it to cover a dead body. The chill of the moonlight, students, रात को, मतलब जैसे हम ये horror films देखते हैं, उसमें we are shown a dark night. So similarly, the dark night is symbolic of death. Okay, again third line, as I told you, is simile. All right, then. Now see the poetic devices, students. This is just what I have covered throughout the poem. Second line in all three stanzas is a question. Third line is a simile. Second and third line is a metaphor, indirect comparison. Then imagery, एक सुंदर सा दृश्य. Imagery मतलब एक दृश्य is created in the fourth line of all stanzas. Then another repeated figure of speech is alliteration in the first line. Now let me just explain a little bit about metaphor and how the metaphor is used in all the three stanzas. Let's just go back to the first stanza. Now see students, in the first stanza, when I say metaphor, metaphor means indirect comparison. All right, indirect comparison. So here, students, the robes of a newborn child, all right, that is a metaphor of new life. All right, the garment is indirectly compared to being bright, so that's a metaphor. So wherever you find indirect comparisons, that is a metaphor. Okay, coming to the third line also, the cloth is the cloth, the bright cloth, the bright garment is again a metaphor of, as I told you, fertility and growth. The bright cloth is a symbol of fertility and growth. All right, so that shows, that's again a metaphor. Even students, the weavers are a metaphor for continuous work. They're working throughout the day non-stop. So that also is an indirect symbol for continuous cycle of life. हमारा जो जीवन चक्र है जो continuous चालू रहता है, आने वाले आते हैं, जाने वाले चले जाते हैं, but we don't stop, right? So that is what beavers are a symbol of. Last, again here students, the white cloth. All right, here there are two symbols, two metaphors. Moonlight chain is a symbol for death. It's indirectly compared to death. Even the dead man's funeral shroud, the cloth of a dead man, all right, again that is a symbol of a life getting over, the stopping of a life, the life that is finished. All right, so in this way students, I'm sure the short poem is clear to you. Now students, you need to go back through the presentation at least two more times to understand the poem in a much better way. All right, when you understand the poem, I'm sure you will be able to answer the questions in your own words. All right, on that note students, I would like to stop today's presentation here. And very soon I'll be back with another topic from your text. With this, students, I would like to say goodbye and take care.